Hello, this is Caymond. Today I will show you how to build 3 different dropper elevators. Now, let me start with the first one. This is actually quite a simple dropper elevator. And the best thing is, this will work in the Nether. So yeah, let me show you how it works. You place some items inside this chest. And then the clock starts going around. The items should be inside this chest. And here you can see them coming. Nice. And here are the items you will need for this build. 2 chests, 10 droppers, 19 observers, 1 hopper, 5 pieces of redstone dust, 1 comparator, and 1 repeater. The best thing about this design is that you can make it as tall as you'd like to, or as short as you'd like to. So yeah, it's quite amazing. Now, let me show you how to build this thing. Let's start by placing down 10 droppers on top of each other, like so. So place 1 down and 10 crouch and keep on jumping. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, like so. And now we can go here, take a observer and place it in here, pointing into this side, like so. So this one will point into this dropper and then these observers will point down, like so. So let's place 9 observers above the bottom one, like so. And now, just start placing down some observers pointing into these observers, like so. Quite a simple design. Then you place a chest on top, or a hopper, or a double chest. It really depends on what you are building. So yeah, then go down, place a hopper and a chest on top. Now, let's place some hoppers. So 16 hoppers and let's go up. Wait a moment, nothing is happening. Well, it's because we need to make a redstone clock. Now, place down 1 comparator, then a repeater behind it, like so. Then take some redstone dust and place it like that. But now when we place items inside, they will go up, like so. It's quite loud. But the next dropper elevator will fix that issue. But yeah, now the items are in here. Quite a simple design and I like it. I like it a lot. Now, this is the second one. The second dropper elevator. And yeah, it's much more silent than the last one. It will make some noise at the beginning, but when it starts going around, it will be a totally silent. So let me show you how it works. Place some items inside. All sound, and now it's quiet. And the items still keep coming up. Quite an amazing design as well. This is my favorite of these. Of these 3. And here are the items you will need for this build. 10 building blocks. You can use any building block you want to. For example, cobblestone, netherrack, planks, whatever you like. And 10, 2 chests. 1 redstone comparator. 1 repeater. 5 redstone dust. 20 observers. 10 droppers. And 10, 1 hopper. Now again, let's start by placing down 10 droppers, like so. So place 1 down, again crouch, and keep on placing the droppers, and then jump up. Place some stone, or any other building block. I have smooth stone in here. Make a row of it up, at the same level as you have these droppers. And then, take 1 observer, pointing into this side, like so. As you can see right in there. And then go placing down these observers all the way up at the same level as these ones, up here. And then leave 1 block gap in here, and then place observers pointing into these observers, like so. Like that. Then a hopper, a chest, and then 1 chest above in here. Like so. Quite simple. And now we need a redstone clock. So, redstone comparator in here, then take some redstone dust, repeater, and then do like that. Quite simple. And again, let's take some items. Let's place 16 redstone dust in here, and then let's go up here. And here comes the items. Like so. Now, the last 2 dropper elevators might be a little bit too expensive for you, because it uses quite a lot of this quartz. So, The last design is a lot more cheaper. I found this design on YouTube, and it was made by Tinker77, link in the description. So yeah, quite an amazing design, and super simple, and it's super old school, and I like it a lot. It's amazing design. So let's place 16 items inside. And it's silent. It doesn't use any observers, and items come up. It's not as fast as those last two designs, but it's still a great design. 11 building blocks again. You can use any building blocks you want to. Cobblestone, planks, or smooth stone, as I use in this design. Then 16 redstone torches, 2 redstone comparators, 3 hoppers, 10 droppers, and then 2 chests. Now, let me show you how to build this thing. So, let's start by placing down 10 droppers, like so. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And then let's go down, place a hopper, and then a chest, like so. Then behind this dropper, like in here, let's place one comparator, like that. Then behind the comparator, let's place one block, and then a redstone torch. And right next to it, a second block, and one comparator pointing into this side. Then let's take the hoppers, crouch, and right-click the second hopper, like so. So they will connect like that. It has to look like that. Now, place down 2 rows of these blocks, like so. This part might be a little bit tricky to do in survival, but as you see right there, let's break every other block, like so. Like that, nice. Now, take redstone torches and place them inside here. All the way up, like this. Let's go up a little bit more. And like that. Now we need to place some redstone torches on the outside. As you can hear, droppers are clicking. And then the last part is a chest on top. Well, not the last part. You still have to place one item, any item inside one of these hoppers. But let's place one redstone torch, for example. Right there. And it locks into this hopper, because there's this redstone torch. Now, let's try this out. Let me place 16 items inside. It goes up quite slowly. But they still get up inside this chest. So 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Quite awesome. And now in Minecraft 1.16, these dropper elevators are amazing in the Nether. When you build your gold farms, or pickling bartering farms. And yeah, for great measure, let me show you how to build a bubble elevator too. So let's just place some blocks like this. Let's just go a couple blocks up so you can see how it works. Like this. Now, break these. Take some signs. Place them on the side so no water can get out. And replace this block with some soul sand. Then place water all the way down. These had to be source blocks. Water source blocks. Now, you go up. You can use this as a elevator by yourself or a item elevator. Check this out. It goes quite fast up there. So yeah. This is the easiest one to do nowadays. But if you're building in the Nether, these ones are amazing. So anyways, if this tutorial was helpful, please hit the like button. And if you haven't already, please consider subscribing. It would really mean a lot to me. But anyways, see you next time. I'm Kaymond. Bye bye. Blah.